your research is impactful. When you're comparing antibodies to use in your experiments, you want to see the supporting data so that you can be confident your results will be valid and reproducible. You understand that no single assay is sufficient to validate an antibody and guarantee it will perform as you expect it to. To ensure our antibodies will work in your experiments, cell signaling technology adheres to the hallmarks of antibody validation. 6 complementary strategies that can be used to determine the functionality, specificity, and sensitivity of an antibody. We'll introduce each of the hallmarks of validation in this video. For an in-depth look, download the companion handbook. Our scientists customize the validation process for every antibody we develop. We consider the role of the target molecule and the sensitivity requirements of the downstream assay and select biologically relevant models. Due to differences in sample preparation, antibody binding conditions, detection methodologies, and other factors, validation must be performed in each application independently, using appropriate protocols and biological models. It's important to remember that a validation result in one application or assay, even when including genetic knockouts, does not apply to another. For example, antibodies that pass Western blot validation using knockouts, CRISPR, or other models may fail to perform appropriately in immunocytochemistry assays or in other settings. Let's explore each strategy. In the binary strategy, we compare antibody performance in positive and negative cells or tissues. These may include models where the endogenous expression levels of the target protein are known to be high and low, genetic knockouts, deletion mutations, or treatments to induce or inhibit expression of the target. In the ranged strategy, we pick models that express high, moderate, and low levels of the target. These may include treatments with agonists, antagonists, or siRNA to increase or decrease target expression. For many targets, a ranged strategy may be more biologically relevant than an all-or-nothing binary strategy. We use orthogonal strategies to complement information obtained from established models. Non-antibody information from previously published studies, expression information mined from RNA or mass spectrometry databases, or other methods can be used to cross-reference and support antibody validation results obtained using other strategies. We use a multiple antibody cross-validation strategy to boost confidence in antibody specificity. Comparison of 2 or more antibodies specific for distinct epitopes of the same target protein or different constituent members of a multimeric protein complex can be informative when used in combination with other validation strategies. In some cases, endogenous expression of the protein of interest in experimental models may be very low, undetectable, or unknown. We employ heterologous expression of the antigenic target, sometimes including recombinant engineering, to aid design of antibody validation experiments. Finally, complementary strategies such as competitive binding analysis can provide valuable supporting information on antibody specificity or functionality and are particularly useful for validating antibodies specific for unique post-translational modifications. We always use complementary strategies in conjunction with assays performed using the other validation hallmarks. Not all validation is equal. CST recommends an antibody only for the applications that meet criteria set in the hallmarks of validation so that you can have confidence in your results.